Hi, welcome to Grandma's German Kitchen. Today is a very special video. I will reveal one of my biggest secrets. Yeah, the secret of the best potato pancakes ever. All my life I did potato pancakes, and like 20 years ago I went in one restaurant and the potato pancakes tasting almost like mine, only a hair better. So after I interviewed the chef a long hours, after a few beers, he told me the secret. And what is the secret? And since then, I'm using this secret. And all my customers love my potato pancakes. So what's the secret? The secret is what you, when you fry them, you have to put a little bit goose fat in your frying pan. So we're using actually sunflower oil and then a little bit goose fat. The goose fat is what makes a potato tasting a little bit more better. So that's the secret. Now you got it. And if you want to eat the potato pancakes, what we're making right now, you can come tomorrow to the farmers market in Brownwood in Florida, the villages, and you can have them. Okay? So let's start with the potato pancakes. Yeah, the ingredients always posted in the description box of the video. But anyway, we have 2 teaspoons fine black pepper, 3 teaspoons sea salt, and 4 teaspoons garlic powder, 1½ cup all-purpose flour, 5 eggs, and then we need actually diced onions, 2 pounds, so we have to wait them later again after we dice them. And we need 5-pound potatoes. We don't need to wait them. We buy a bag of 5-pound golden potatoes. You probably experience when you're grating potatoes, they absorb oxygen and they're getting black very fast. So that's a there is like thing you can prevent that. But anyway, we don't need to do first the potatoes. No, no, we do first the onions. And then the potatoes we do last. So this mandoline you can cut slice, and here's an additional inlay which are a lot of small knives, so we make very small stripes. So that's then you can adjust also how big the stripes are, but short stripes we call dice. So you got from the center short stripes, which is dice, and from the outside you get long stripes. In order to avoid that, we cut the outside a few times and cut the stripes a little bit shorter, and then we have dice. So, and then you start from the top to the bottom with the mandoline, go down. This is very easy, but don't use your fingers, use the rester holder. So now I cannot go more because this is touching the mandoline, so I push a little bit on that button here and push this a little bit out and go up and down. And not always, we don't want the dirt in it. So see, there we have our onions, very fine diced by hand cut, so no bitter. And so we need 400 grams, no, actually we need 2 pounds of that. Yeah, my grandma, she grated the potatoes by hand. But these days in the year 2020, I think it's not good to do that by hand. I mean, if you want to scrape your skin off, you can do that by hand too. If I have a big catering business, I probably use my big machine and do for hundreds of people the potato pancakes. But you at home don't have a big machine. So that's the thing I will show you here, my KitchenAid. My KitchenAid is 24 years old, and I have an attachment here, and I want to try that out. It works pretty good for you at home. So you can have also a food processor. The thing is, what you need is the grating plate, you know, for the machine. You can have more fine, and you can have more coarse. So we go with the fine side, so the fine side up, and then we put this in. Like this, then we close this. Let's see, somehow, okay, let's see it works. Yeah, looks like working. So before you grate the potatoes, I don't peel them, because under the skin is good vitamins and nutrients, very good. So, but I inspect them, and if I find a bad spot, I take that out, right? So you wash them very nicely, inspect them, and then we grate them with the machine. So that goes. Potatoes are a little bit too big here, so we put this like this. And then we have a stuffer here. No, don't put the finger in. It's coming nice out. The bad thing on this, the end stays on the top, but after a while we can empty that, and don't worry about that. So we put everything in and grate that very nicely, okay? Yeah, I mentioned in the beginning that the potatoes get very fast black when you grate them. So in order to prevent that, we put a little bit lemon juice over. Lemon juice, the high acid lemon juice will prevent that the oxygen goes in the potatoes. The potatoes stay light. They don't get black fast. So perfect, right? So now we can do more. So now, before we open this up, we take here, mix this again with a little bit lemon juice. Not too much, we don't want it bitter. A little bit lemon juice. And then we take nice of those stripes. Take like 1/3, separate them. Nice one. 1/4 or 1/3, maybe a little bit more. So that's good. That's for our texture later. And now what we can do, we open this up and you see here on the top is all the junk which didn't go through. So we put it right in here. And take everything out. Ready for dishwashing. You can use any good blender, and so before we do that, we take all the ingredients what we had, like all-purpose flour, the pepper, the sea salt, and the garlic powder. We put this all together and mix it nicely. So nicely, a little bit. And then we take our blender and take a little bit from the potatoes in here. A little bit juice. And we have our eggs. Remember, we have 5 eggs, so we put 2 eggs in it. And then we mix it a little bit. Oh, there's a little bit eggshell in it. Maybe a little bit more of those. That's good. We mix it a little bit. Not too much, just gets smooth a little bit. Can you see? We want to have a nice texture. So then we take like 1/3 or 1/4 of the flour mixed with a seasoning and mix it again. Now I prepared another bowl. We put this in. Let me see, it's coming out like this. Yeah. Good. Now we take the next load. Since you're still watching this video, you may consider to support this channel by subscribing to this channel. I would appreciate that. Also, you can hit the bell, which is a notification bell. If I bring a new video out, you get notified, so you don't miss the video. Thank you. Now back to our video instruction. That looks good already. You will now be surprised, but the next step is, because we want to have a nice texture like grandma grated it by hand, and we cheat a little bit. We take that, what we took separate, put this in, mix it nicely up, just come as well, open up now, because we have a lot of liquid. See, that's good. And now the surprising, our 2 pounds of onions. Oh, they, where are my 2 pounds of onions? Are here. 2 pounds of onions. Nice, fine, diced by hand. And we mix it under. And that's our preparation for our potato pancakes. Now we can start fry them. What I use is sunflower oil. Sunflower oil is a light oil. In Europe they use that a lot. And so we can put a little bit in here, a little bit in here. So I have 2 sizes of frying pan to show you. Each size will work at home. So then we put some goose fat in, like tablespoon in the beginning. Later on we add half tablespoon later we put in. So, like I said, that's our secret. Then I transfer the mix to a nice smaller container, so I can handle that very nicely. And we use like a 2 ounces ladle. So we mix this again when we go, mix this nice. And then we take like 1 and put it right in a small frying pan. This is a small one, so you can see you make them like half of the frying pan, and they're tapped that on top, so it's getting a little bit thinner. You want them nicely thin, not too thick. So now the other side, and we tap that a little bit. So now we take the bigger frying pan. Let's see, is this hot already? Yeah. See, the frying pan is a little bit bigger. You can make like 3. So now it's really brown on the corner here, so let's see how it looks. Oh, not too bad. So I think, see this brown here? You can see brown all around. Now we twist them around. And this way too. I don't flip them like this, because then the grease goes on my hands and I burn myself. So I always, when I flip them, I hold it back. Can you see? Like this. So, perfect. Now this here is pretty done. Let's see how it looks. Very good. You can leave that a little bit more browner on the other side if you want. Nice crunchy, yeah? But for me it's good enough. I use them tomorrow on the farmer's market, and I don't need them too dark because I warm them up. So we do here another one. So if you want to eat that, you come tomorrow to the farmer's market Saturday in the villages in Brownwood. Now you know the secret of the best potato pancakes ever. Thank you for watching, and it would be nice if you give me a comment. I don't get much comment on my videos, even good or bad. And maybe you'll give me a like. Thank you very much for watching this video. See you next time. Bye bye.